Hello and welcome. Today we are going to talk about how to get out of the box and generate new ideas. Based on a TED Talk by Giovanni Crozza, in this TED Talk, Crozza shares some powerful strategies for thinking creatively and generating innovative ideas. First, let's talk about why this is such an important topic. In today's fast-paced and rapidly changing world, the ability to generate new ideas and innovative is more important ever, and whether an entrepreneur, a student or a professional, you need to able to come up with new and creative solutions to problems and challenges. So how do we do that? According to Crozza, there are several key strategies we can use. Approach problems from different angles and perspectives. This means looking at a problem from different angles and asking questions like what if and why not. It also means being willing to challenge our assumptions and think outside the box. Crozza gives the example of company that wanted to reduce the weight of their product instead of just trying to make the product lighter. They asked themselves, what if we could eliminate the need for the product to be heavy in the first place? This led to a breakthrough in their thinking, a new lighter product. Be cautious and open-minded. This means being willing to explore different ideas and possibilities. It also means being willing to learn from others, seek out new experience. Crozza gives the example of Leonardo Vinci, who has only a great artist but also crucial or open-minded thinker. Da Vinci was constantly exploring new ideas and new areas of knowledge, which lead to some of his most gardening combined different elements to create something new. This means taking inspiration from different sources and combining them in new and creative ways. For example, a musician might combine different musical styles to create a unique sound. Crozza emphasizes the importance of not just copying and others have done, but instead taking inspiration from a wide range of sources and creating something truly original. Embracing failure as a valuable learning experience. This means willing to take risks and try new things. Even if they might not work out, failure can be valuable learning experience and lead new insights and ideas. Crozza gives the example of Thomas Edison, who famously failed many times before finally inventing the light bulb. Edison saw each failure as a step closer or to success, rather than a setback. Now let's dive deeper into each of these strategies and how you can apply them in your own life and work. First, let's talk about approaching problems from different angles and perspective. This is all about breaking out of your comfort zone and exploring new ways of thinking. One way to do this is to ask yourself what if questions. For example, if you are trying to come up with a new product, a new idea, you might ask yourself, what if we could make a product that solves two problems and wants? Or what if we could create product that does not need to be plugged in? These kind of questions can help you think outside the box and come with truly innovative ideas. Another way to approach problems from different angles is to challenge your assumptions. We all have assumptions and biases that can limit our thinking. For example, if you assume that curtain technology is too expensive to implement, you might not even consider it as an option. But what if that assumption is wrong? By questioning your assumption and challenging is your own thinking, you can open up new possibilities and ideas. The second strategy is to be curious and open-minded. This is all about being willing to explore new ideas and possibilities even if they might seem outside of your comfort zone. Croza emphasizes the importance of being a lifelong learner and constantly seeking out new knowledge and experience. This can include things like attending workshops, reading books and new topics, or even just having conversation with people who have different perspectives than your own. One key aspect of being curious and open-minded is to embrace uncertainty. When you are exploring new ideas and possibilities, you are inevitably going to encounter and us to embrace it as opportunity for growth and learning. By being comfortable with uncertainty, we can open ourselves up to new possibilities and ideas that we might have otherwise overlooked. The third strategy is to combine different elements to create something new. This is all about taking inspiration from different sources and combining them in new innovative ways. Croza gives the example of Steve Jobs, who famously drew inspiration from a wide range of sources to create Apple's iconic product. Jobs was known from combining elements from different industries such as design, technology and fashion to create something truly unique and innovative. But combining different elements is not just about copying what others have done. It's about taking inspiration and adding your own unique sign. Croza encourages us to think about what we can bring to the table that's different and original. This might be a unique, perspectively a new way of combining existing elements or completely original idea. Finally, the fourth strategy is to embrace failure as a valuable learning experience. This is all about taking risks and trying new things even if they might not work out. Failure is inevitable when you are trying to generate new ideas, but it's also a valuable learning experience. By embracing failure, we can learn from our mistakes and use that knowledge to improve and refine our ideas. One key aspect of embracing failure is to be resilient when things don't go as planned. It's important to be able to bounce back and keep going. Croza gives the example of J.K. Rowling, who faced rejection after rejections before finally getting her first Harry Potter book published. Rowling's resilience and determination are a key part of what made her successful. So those are four keys strategies for getting out of the box and generating new ideas. But how can you apply these strategies in your own life and work? One way is to start by asking yourself what if questions. When you are facing a problem or challenge, try to think about it from different angles and ask yourself what if questions to challenge your assumptions and open up new possibilities. Another way to apply these strategies is to seek out new experiences and knowledge This might include attending workshops, reading books on new topics, or even just having conversation with people who have different perspective than your own. It's also important to be willing to take risks and try new things, embrace failure as a valuable learning experience, and use that knowledge to refine and improve your ideas. In conclusion, getting out of the box and generating new ideas is a crucial skill in today's fast-paced and rapidly changing world. By using these four key strategies, you can break out of your comfort zone, explore new ideas and possibilities, and create truly innovative solutions to challenges you face. So embrace your crusty tactics and be open to new ideas. You never know where they might take you.